tying some things up for tomorrow.
Just be ready to play.
Trey, you mentioned tomorrow, really big game against Alabama. Do you prefer to have one game under your belt, get a, in a new arena, as opposed to having a bye, or would you have rather had a bye?
It don't matter to me. Last year, you know, we had a bye, and it kind of, I guess, maybe nipped us in the butt. We got a lost Ole Miss, and they had played a game. So we're just going in ready to play, and, you know, just above all, just playing our game and executing the way we know how to execute.
What's the main memory you have of those two close games against Alabama during your season?
I just honestly remember they could have gone either way at Alabama, at, you know, at Tennessee. So I just think that we just have to be ready, you know, from tip, just to control the game, play, you know, at our tempo, play at our pace. And I think if we do that, we'll be good.
They saw you before this 9-game stretch that you closed the season out with. They didn't see kind of this version of the team. How much different do you think that's an advantage that you have, that you're kind of a different looking team than you were when you guys faced each other?
You know, I think when they played us both times, you know, I wasn't playing my best, and you know, it was more, I guess you could say that, yeah, I guess you're right, yeah, you know, I wasn't as aggressive, and I was kind of going through whatever I was going through, so, you know, now just ready to play tomorrow and just focus on that.
Trey, you feel like they always kind of play you guys tough, it seems like they're always kind of hard-fought and physical and pretty close.
Well, yeah, definitely. I think that they're a very good team. I think they play anybody close, and I think that, you know, the biggest thing for us is just making sure that we're ready to play and ready from tip to play them. And like I said, they're a great team, so we just got to be ready to play.
What concerns you most about them, Trey?
You know, I don't really have too many concerns. I just think we have to be able to contain Trevor Rose and Trevor Lacey, and I think if we do that and just rebound the ball well, I think we'll be good.
Do you think you guys maybe coasted a little bit in the second half there after you guys were 19 early in the first half?
I don't know if I'd call it coast. I think, you know, just our typical, we kind of careless turnovers, don't defend like we know how to, and, you know, the lead gets decreased, so we just got to make sure that, you know, we lock in and we're ready to play at all times.
How much should y'all talk, if at all, before the game about just what happened last year and avoiding that fate again?
We didn't talk really about before the game, but just, you know, throughout this week, just knowing, you know, that it's going to be tough and we got to make sure that we're ready and just, you know, preparing yourself for a long weekend, you know, not thinking, you know, what ifs, you know, just play every game how we know how to play and we'll be good.
They were able to get back in the second half. It seemed the first half after they got, I think, the first 4 points, y'all seemed to really wear them down. How much was that focus with their lack of depth to kind of get on them early and see what could happen?
Just kind of what we try to do every team, just kind of, you know, pounce on them, try to get them down, and then just, you know, gradually wear on and just do our thing. So I think that that's what we try to do, and I think for us, that's our game, so we just got to be ready to do that for all 40 minutes.
Thank you.
Good night, I mean, if there's going to be a fatigue factor, there's going to be a lull in your legs in the next game, because, you know, it's a pretty quick turnaround. But, you know, on the other hand, it's nice to get, like I said, it's nice to get a feel for these Rams, a feel for these goals, a feel for this gym, and get a game under your belt. And so, but I think we'll be fresh for tomorrow.
Thanks, Colin. Is there a sense, Scholar, that maybe it's not just an elimination game in this tournament tomorrow, but with the NCAA tournament?
Right, well, I mean, I think that, you know, both teams know that, mm-hmm. And those are always fun games to play in when there's a lot on the line. You know, we're fighting not only for an SEC championship, but for our NCAA tournament lives, and Alabama's the next step in that, and we're just going to come out and do the best we can, play hard, and I think as long as we do what we're supposed to do, then everything will be fine.
What happened in the second half? You guys just kind of uneven, I guess.
Yeah, there was a little bit of a lull. We got a little bit complacent, and you know, we got to do a better job of, when we're up on teams like that, really putting teams away, getting to a bigger lead. But give credit where it's due. Mississippi State did a good job second half, driving to the basket. They got some shots to fall in the second half that they didn't in the first half, and so, but you know, they're a good young team and got some really athletic guys who can get to the basket, and so, you know, give credit where it's due. Give credit to